Hey everyone, welcome once again to my channel DIY Savvy Mommy, and welcome if you are new here. I'm Kshitij and I love making DIY art, home decor and lifestyle videos. And in today's video, I'm creating DIYs inspired by Singapore. Yes, Singapore's National Day is just around the corner, so this video is just right on time. Singapore is an island country and a major tourist destination known for its world-class architecture, beautiful gardens, especially orchid gardens, man-made waterfalls and its Changi Airport. In today's video, I will try my level best to recreate my favorite Singapore elements. And if you enjoy watching today's video, please do consider subscribing to my channel and hit the like button. So let's begin with the video. For the first DIY, I'm creating the super tree of gardens by the bay, and for that I took a ribbon holder and a cardboard roll and glued it on to the ribbon holder like so, and then I took some barbecue sticks and started gluing them to the cardboard roll in a tapered form, and I glued them at the base and then one end to the topmost end of the cardboard roll so that it looks more like a like something that is tapering to the top. Once I had glued the barbecue sticks on all the sides, I cut out the excess, and this leaves me with small pieces of barbecue sticks, and then I had a styrofoam cut out and in circle shape, and I glued it on top of the cardboard roll like so. Then I cut some more barbecue skewers in small size and started gluing them all around the circle of the cardboard roll. And this is going to form the branches of the super tree. I glued them at one edge and I tried my level best to make them equidistant and let them glue it perfectly and then dry up. So here we have a basic structure of my super tree. I have the base and the top branches complete, and then next step would be to cover the base with some green moss. The original trees are also supported by poles on all sides, and it also acts as a vertical garden, and it is covered with greenery and flowers all over. So I'm going to recreate the same thing, and similarly I'm going to cover this entire structure with green moss so that it replicates the original. Once the base was complete, I started wrapping a floral wire onto the branches of the super tree like so, and this is going to make the zigzag pattern that is on the super trees. To add the element of lights, I wrapped string lights all over the branches of the super tree. And in the similar fashion, how I wrapped the floral wire, I wrapped the lights. The super trees in Gardens by the Bay light up at night, and there's a light and sound show that happens with the help of lighting the trees. The lights are powered with solar power, so it is environment friendly also. And similarly, I have covered all the branches with lights. I wrapped them all over the branches like so to make a zigzag pattern and to cover entirely the branches. And I used string lights in all the colors, so it basically represents the changing colors of the super trees. I wrapped the lights to the base of the tree also for a lighted and brighted effect. And this is my super tree almost done. And this is a trash to treasure project, and I tried my level best to recreate the masterpiece. And it looks great as a night lamp or an outside porch decor, or if you like, you can gift it to your friend also as a souvenir. Do let me know how you like my little super tree and how I recreated it. Did I nail it or fail it? And let me tell you about the challenge today. Today I am participating in the Real Housewives of Craft Country challenge, hosted by Tammy from The Rusted Willow. And the co-hosts are Simply Becky DIY and Jankar Nekar DIY. All three of them are super amazing creators, and I have linked their channels in the description box below, along with the playlist for the other creators participating. So do check out all of them as they create DIYs from their own home country. And let's begin with the second DIY. For the second DIY, I created a bottle art with the national flower of Singapore, that is orchid. I took an empty bottle and I painted it with the ocean blue chalk paint, and this blue represents the sea in Singapore, and I painted orchids on this bottle to illustrate the national flower. However, I lost the entire clip of detailed painting of the first flower. I tried hard to retrieve it, but I couldn't. I'm so sorry about that. To paint the orchids, I used white acrylic color, and I painted the base. And then to do the entire shading, I took a purple chalk paint, and I made strokes to make the inner portion of the flower, and to make the center part, that is the inside of the flower, I took yellow chalk paint, and I painted the inside. And this is how my entire illustration of the orchid flower looks. For the finishing touches, I wrapped jute twine at the top of the bottle neck, and then I added a pearl and a seashell to the twine to represent the beaches of Singapore. Thank you. So this is all for today, and let me know how you liked today's video and which DIY out of the two was your favorite. And thanks a lot for watching, and please do subscribe and hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and I shall see you all very soon in the next video. Until then, take good care of yourself, and bye bye. Happy crafting.